Can you tell me about this chapter? You have not read? Very nice. Yes, over here, Kunal, tell me. Kunal, tell me about the chapter. Krish, get up and go change your seat. Never mind, you can stay without the book. And yes, Simran, what do you find funny about everything? What do we call people who keep on laughing without a reason? Without any reason, and of course, even if the situation has a humor or not, and yeah. No, kafi dinon se nahi, it's been a long time. Right, from, I'm asking you the reason here. Why? What do we call, or why is it that she has to laugh always, unnecessarily? Yes, Kunal, tell me about the chapter. She goes to her own house. Yeah, that's Dhruvapuram. Aditya, don't act smart. We know how smart you are, right? Not even a little bit. So don't worry. Silence. Silence. Yes, Navya, tell me, please hurry up. Let's just give me the answer and so I can start with the chapter. Now, students here, please listen, sit down. What is this chapter about? As I told you, it is about a post-war condition, right? And how difficult it is to move on in life when in the war has caused such a big loss, right? So before the war, what had happened? The narrator's mother, she had told her that you must remember one address, that if we survive after the war and we want our lives to come back to normal, please remember this address. What was the address? Address was 46 Markani Street. This was not the address of a relative or an aunt or an uncle. It was the address of an acquaintance. So she knew this lady, right? That is Mrs. Darling. But when the situation here before the war, it started becoming tense. So she started visiting her house. And she promised her that, yes, I'll take good care of your belongings, because they were Jews and it could be quite possible that they would be taken away anytime, right? So rather that their home is, robbed of valuable things, it was better if it was kept safe. So Mrs. S, she believed the lady, she gave her belongings, and then family went away, and now the daughter comes back after the war, right? After a long time, she was able to bring herself to look at the things that belonged to her mother. So she remembered the address her mother had told her, yes, and she decided to go there. What happened the first time she went? What happened the first time she went? Did the lady allow her to enter the house? No, she did not. She just pretended that she did not know her. These four boys here. Quiet. Krishna, come here. With Krish. So first instant when she went there, the lady did not or pretended not to recognize her. But the girl was able to make out, I have come to the right address, because she was wearing her mother's cardigan, right? Yes, and so after a couple of days, again, she decided that she wanted her mother's belongings. She wanted things that belonged to her mother. So she made an attempt there, and luckily for her, the mother was not at home. Right, Mrs. Darling was not there at home, and her daughter allowed her inside. So from the moment she entered the house, what was she able to notice? What were the things that she noticed? Yes, she noticed her mother's things. And right from the entrance and to the room where she went, she could see things that she were familiar with, right? So when it was the candle stand, and as they entered here, so it was the plate, so the crockery, even the table cloth, right? So what did she not like about this whole atmosphere was the way the things were kept, or the way the things were being used, right? And so now, yes, so she's noticing all those things. Someone is still talking. Someone is there. See, class 11, you are not small children. I don't have to tell you again and again. Yes, page 13. Come and look at your books now. Won't you sit down? Asked the girl. She held open the door of the living room and I went inside past her. I stopped horrified. I was in a room I knew and did not know. I found myself in the midst of things I did want to see again, but which oppressed me in the strange atmosphere. So she followed the girl inside the room. She's very horrified, right? And what are the things? She knows those things, but they are in a very different environment. And she's not very happy about the way they are kept or the way they're being used, okay? Right? Or because of the tasteless way everything was arranged. So sometimes you don't need a very expensive crockery and things, you know, to make a good impression. Even in your simple crockery, you can make a good impression. It depends on how you arrange the things and how you make the presentation. So she did not like how the things had been kept. And we keep things in a proper place, in a proper manner, when we know their value, right? So if I really appreciate something that I bought or someone has got for me, I am going to have a special place for it. It's not going to be carelessly kept here or there. So she did not like the way the things had been tastelessly arranged, right? So they were not kept in a nice manner. Because of the ugly furniture or the muggy smell that hung there, we had discussed this yesterday. I don't know, but I scarcely dared to look around me. So the things which were there, the furniture she did not like, the whole environment there, that smell. That means, yes, it was not an airy room. It was not taken care of properly, right? I don't know, but I scarcely dared to look around me. The girl moved a chair. I sat down and stared at the woolen tablecloth. I rubbed it. My fingers grew warm from rubbing. I followed the lines of the pattern. Somewhere on the edge, there should be a burn mark that had never been repaired. So the tablecloth also belonged to her mother. So she knew it very well that there was a burn mark and no one had got the time to repair it. And even now, yes, these people have also not repaired it and they've just spread the tablecloth like that. My mother will be back soon, said the girl. I've already made tea for her. Will you have a cup? Thank you. I looked up. The girl put cups ready on the tea table. She had a broad bag just like her mother. That was one of the memories that she had of Mrs. Darling, right? So she could just see her from a distance and realize. So just like a mother, she looked like. She poured tea from a white pot. All it had was a gold border on the lid. I remembered. So even that pot, it belonged to her mother. And with the passage of time, what had happened to that gold border? It had got faded, right? Yes. She opened a box and took some spoons out of it. That's a nice box, I heard my own voice. It was a strange voice, as though each sound was different in this room. So she's very surprised at her reaction. She's very surprised at the way she is, behaving and talking. And saying things which are very unnatural to her. Looking at the tablecloth and looking at the box, which she knows it belongs to her mother. Even then, she's complimenting it, right? It's a nice box. Oh, you know about them? She had turned around and brought me my tea. She laughed. My mother says it is antique. What was antique? Last bench, who's there behind Krish? Yes, Khushi, please stand up. What does antique mean? Antique means? Antique are old things, right? Yes, so we have many older things. But what is special about these antique things? They're valuable, right? And they are special, right? That with the passage of time, they become valuable, right? Sit down. So there's something special about the box. It could be the way it was made or the designs on it that made it very valuable. Yes, silence, please. I should not have to say this again. You are senior students. You know how to behave. You know how to keep quiet. Right? And still I can hear a sound in the class. Much better. Now it's better. Oh, you know about them? She turned around. Yes, we have got lots more. So it's not only this box. We have many things like this. We have many antique things. She pointed round the room. See for yourself. Did the girl need any kind of reminder? Did she need to be pointed out or told that these are antique things? These are valuable things. I had no need to follow her hand. I knew which things she meant. I just looked at the still life over the tea table. What's the still life on the tea table? As a child, I had always fancied the apple on the pewter plate. So on the tea table, you know, you keep some knickknacks over there, you know, right? So that is a still life. So there's a pewter plate or it could be a mug or it could be something, you know, like a souvenir or something which you have kept on the table. So these are things she has grown up with, right, Ananya? Yes, Harshita? pewter plate? So pewter is a kind of metal, right? So you have these darkish brownish color, you know, plates here, like something like your brass plates. We use it for everything, she said. Which one? The pewter plate, and which might have an engraving of an apple on it. We use it for everything. Once we even ate off all the plates hanging there. You know, when you go to certain places, you would notice that even on the walls, you find these plates or the plaques hanging, right? They are very different from the plates that we have as crockery. So those plates here, they have been made for as commemorating maybe certain events, right? So they are not a part of the crockery, okay? So here, look at this girl. She says that once we even ate off the plates hanging there on the wall. Very strange. I wanted to so much, but it wasn't anything special. So what do you think? What is happening in the narrator's mind at this moment when the girl tells about her behavior and the way her family has been there treating their belongings? Is it making her happy or sad, or she's having this feeling, or she's even more horrified? Mixed feelings, yes. I had found the burn mark on the tablecloth. The girl looked questioningly at me. Yes, I said. You get so used to touching all these lovely things in the house, you hardly look at them anymore. So when we enter home, we take things for granted. It's sometimes, you know, maybe later in the day, we notice, okay, some kind of change has been done. Something is missing. Something has been taken away. Something else put in its place, isn't it? So when we are there growing up in such kind of environment with all these things around us, we barely notice them. So this is what she's telling here. You only notice when something is missing because it has to be repaired, or because you have lent it, for example. Was there any special purpose why the girl spoke these lines? Why did she say this? What did she want to express? So this time it is not going to be multiple choice, it's going to be subjective. So learn to think and learn to write also. Yes. So what was it? She's showing her, you know, like, of course, she's not happy with the way things are, you know, like kept, and how they're using things without their, you know, like permission, and how they took it for granted that no one is going to come back. So she's giving her a reminder that we remember with those things are not there in a home when they have to go for repairing, or when you have lent it to someone else. Right? Is she making a reference to anything particular here? Last voice, stand up, please. Mohit, your name is? Get up. Which line am I reading? Am I asking you? Nalini can find out himself. Again, I heard the unnatural sound of my voice and went on. She can't believe that she's speaking like this because she's so hurt, right? She's angry also. I remember my mother once asked me if I would help her polish the silver. It was a very long time ago, and I was probably bored that day, or perhaps I had to stay at home because I was ill, as she had never asked me before. So my mother had never asked me to help her in polishing the silver, but that day, because I was at home, so she asked me to help her. I asked her which silver she meant. See, as I say, we are there using those things every day. We do not realize their value. She did not know, as she replied, surprised, that it was the spoons, the forks, and the knives. Of course. Which silver are you talking about? It's not some special silver, you know, plates you have, or your silver glasses here, which you might be having as fond memories. You know, when you were small, you might have been gifted these silver things. Yes. So, of course, it's a part of growing up. You know, like we have our relatives and grandparents giving you, might have a silver spoon and a silver glass. right? All these here. So, but here, what is the silver that her mother was talking about? She was talking about the cutlery in particular. And they were using it every day. And she never knew that it was silver. And silver has to be polished to bring the shine back. Otherwise, it becomes very dull. And that was a strange thing. I didn't know the cutlery we ate off every day was silver. Is she giving a hint to the girl? Do you think she's trying to give a hint to the girl? That you don't realize the things that you are using. That I know what you are using, isn't it? The girl laughed again. I bet you don't know it is either. I looked intently at her. So she's there trying to give this message to her. Even you don't know the cutlery that you're using is silver. What we eat with, she asked. Well, do you know? She hesitated. She walked to the sideboard and wanted to open a drawer. I look, it's in here. So she says, let me check if our cutlery is silver or not. She had her hand on the, I jumped up. I was forgetting the time. I must catch my train. So earlier the girl was in a hurry to come to this address. And now she seems to be even more a greater hurry to leave. No, I must go. I walked to the, she had her hand on the drawer. Don't you want to wait for my mother? No, I must go. I walked to the door. The girl pulled the drawer open. I can find my own way. As I walked down the passage, I heard the jingling of spoons and forks. So she's looking at the spoons and the forks. That are they really of silver? At the corner of the road, I looked up at the nameplate, Markani Street, it said. I had been at number 46. The address was correct, but now I didn't want to remember it anymore. I wouldn't go back there because the objects that are linked in your memory with the familiar life of former times instantly lose their value when severed from them. You see them again in strange surroundings. So things you've been using, yes, Khushi, silent now. In your childhood, when they're taken away from you and you see them in strange surroundings, they lose their value. And this is what happened to her. Okay, right. And what should have I done with them in a small rented room where the shreds of blackout paper still hung along the windows and no more than a handful of cutlery fitted in the narrow table drawer? I resolved to forget the address. Of all the things I had to forget, that would be the easiest. So what excuse does she give to herself? Why doesn't she want to take those things? What is the excuse that she makes to herself? Yes, that she had a small rented room and there were so many things, they would not fit in. What was the reality? What was the reality? She was hurt. What had happened to the memory that she had of those beautiful things? It had been spoiled, right? She did not want to use those things which had been kept in such a disrespectful manner, which had not been used, without knowing the true value, isn't it? So yes, so she decided that I am never coming back here, and she wanted to forget this address. So what about the memories? What about things? Is she going to forget them? She's going to forget the things? The memories of the things, will she forget? No. Right? But she did not want to spoil the memories that she had by, staying there for longer or taking them back with her and, remembering that how these people had used it. So she thought it's better. I just forget the address and she would never come back to collect her belongings. Okay, right. We will discuss the question answers tomorrow. Mm-hmm.